Today, I'm going to show you how to move from a screenshot to a vector design that you can actually edit in Figma in a few minutes. You must have found yourself in the situation where you had a screenshot and you wish you could actually edit it. So we're going to look at that today. And also, how to start from an idea that you may have sketched on paper and take that idea into information architecture within FigJam. The idea for this video started in class when I was teaching my students how to create a scenario from a persona to move into specific scenario tasks. And I had this template that I wanted them to use. It was actually a screenshot. In the past, what I've done is within Figma Design, I would create a template for them, and maybe I would give them the template as a starting point, make it components with text properties that they can come here and just change the text. That's good and nice, but definitely it took me a while to create this template so that it's nice and reusable. However, I had this really good screenshot for a usage scenario template that I found on Google and that could be leveraged. So I thought, why not use Figma Make to make this an editable template? So let me show you how to do this. If you're starting in Figma Make, when you're adding an attachment, you can actually upload an image. Now, the format for the image is it has to be either a PNG or a JPEG. If you have an image that's neither of these, I want to show you how to actually convert it. Now, I want to open this image that has a WebP format because I've downloaded it from the web. If I double click it right here, I'm opening it in Preview, which is the Mac native application. I'm sure there is something equivalent in Windows. And if you come to File, under File, you have the option to export. And this is where you can change the format to either a PNG or a JPEG, which is what Figma Make will need. And clicking Save, I have this now available for me on the desktop. So now, coming back to Figma Make, if I add an attachment, click on Upload an Image, this is where I can see my PNG. I'm going to open it and just give a very simple prompt. Nothing much is needed. You can even say, create this image. Now that Figma Make is done loading, you will see it actually created my persona the way it is. But for some reason, it had an error with the image itself. It just added the same text in the image format. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the point and edit to further prompt Figma Make. Do you see it? It's right here at the bottom. I will select the image and replace with a professional female image. And I'm prompting it to do that. You can even do this change at the next stage when we move to the design. But since I'm using Make anyways, I would like to change here, and then I will copy it into a design file. Meanwhile, while this is happening, what I need next is an actual Figma design file. So I'm going to open that. Coming back to Make, I can see the changes were done. So I will come right here to this copy to design feature. This should be available in all accounts that are professional or education. Clicking on copy design, I'm bringing that very quickly and clicking Command V to actually paste the persona. And you will see this template now is in vector. If I open this file, untitled, you will see everything is in it. And also, it's been created in auto layout, which is great. That means my students can come here, edit the text, and change it as they want. If I wanted to go one step further, I could even transform this text, add text property to it so that they can change it from the right property panel. But like this, you see, you can take any image, create it in Figma Make, and copy it back to design. Now, let's move to the next tip that will make your workflow so much faster. Have you had this situation where you come up with an idea, brainstorming, you are sketching on paper, and you're creating different things on paper? I love doing this. I always love thinking first on paper with a pen before I jump into the tool and get caught up into the details. Let's say I did some brainstorming, created some information architecture, and now I want to go to FigJam to actually create this. I'm going to show you the quickest shortcut, which is using ChatGPT even with Figma, so you learn that trick as well. So what I did is I took a photograph of my image with my phone, and From my phone, I sent this prompt, Figma, create this attached information architecture. And right now, the integration between ChatGPT and Figma allows you to do this. If you want to learn more about this, you can watch my other video I'm linking to you up there that shows you how to achieve this integration from ChatGPT. But now, if I open this in FigJam, it has exactly all the things I drew on this paper, which is fantastic. And these are the tips I wanted to share with you today to move very quickly from paper and screenshots into editable vector designs in Figma. If you have any topics that you want to learn more about, please put them in the comments. I would love to cover them for you. Thank you for watching.